you know, as you approach art history as this kind of baggage of what has been done as a predecessor, how do you reinterpret it? You know, how do you make a bronze so that it still has the kind of authenticity of an early bronze work, the kind of primitive scenario of that, but how do you kind of disassemble that, make it a reanimation, leave the scars, turn it into something else? How do you work with a mobile after the fact that Calder owns mobiles? You know, how are you going to address the fact that you want to make a body of work that has been done very well by another artist?
Yeah, and so I mean, a lot of your early sculptures, and particularly some of the ones that, that we have upstairs, grappled with that conundrum. You know, how do you continue to make art that is significant and meaningful today with all of art history behind you?
Yeah, I mean, it's also materials lend themselves to different attitudes. You know, I mean, we're, you know, what does it mean to be making large monumental sculpture out of fabric? What does it mean to sew those things? What are the kind of polarities of materials that lend themselves to gender issues or socio-political issues? All of these things, to me, you know, have a very kind of formal arrangement of how I identify with prior predecessors in art history and the way that sculptures were made in time, but also, you know, how is it that we can use them and kind of gratifyingly push these things together in this kind of hybrid form so it means something else.